And Srila Prabhupada is founder Acharya of ISKCON. So the pattern that we have is that we will first have Sri Namamrita, that is the section where we read about glories of holy names, that is glories of chanting, and then we'll discuss on the actual topic. So today's topic is session 40, that is on Srila Prabhupada. So we'll try to understand more about him. We'll try to watch some of his videos because it is an online session. So definitely watching all the sessions may not be possible, but maybe after the session, I will share the links to the other session so you all can go through it. Sri Namamrita. You all can see my screen, right?
Yes.
Yes, Prabhu.
So, following in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srila Prabhupada distributed the Maha Mantra freely in the West. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, for those who don't know, so Krishna is coming again and again in this material world just to claim us all fallen souls, because we are so much illusioned when we come to this material world that even though, so like there was a question as well raised to Yudhishthir Maharaj by Yaksh, that what is the most wonderful thing that you see in this material world? And then he replied that every day we find so many people are dying. We know, we can see our grandparents dying, father dying, mother dying, or relatives dying. Some way or the other people are dying. But still, we are living our life in such a fashion that we are never going to die. So how that is possible? That is, the reason is that whenever we come to this material world, we are covered with so many ignorance. There are five kinds of ignorance by which we'll get covered. So so we'll not go into details of that, but essentially we all can understand that this material world is a creation of which we can consider as a material jail, which is also created by Krishna. But here the governing body is Durga. Durga means Durga is jail, and Durga is superintendent of jail. So this material world is nothing more but a jail for a conditioned soul, so that they can get the real understanding. Somehow or the other, they can come to the platform that basically they can only be satisfied by serving Krishna. So when any living entity revolt against Krishna, they think that, okay, they can be the supreme enjoyer, or why we should serve Krishna, maybe we can try to serve someone else. So we come to this material world and we try to serve different people. Someone tries to serve their parents, spouses, kids, family, extended nation, everything. But neither he is satisfied, neither the person who that person is serving is satisfied. So one of the very common example is Mahatma Gandhi. So Mahatma Gandhi was trying his very best to serve the nation, but nation was not satisfied. And nation shot him down. That is, one person who was not satisfied, he shot him down. So we can understand that whatever service someone is doing to this material world will not neither satisfy that particular person, neither will satisfy the person whom he's serving. So the only thing that is satisfying to the heart is when someone is serving Krishna. So when person come to this material world, he is covered with so many illusions. Because of that, like, it is very wonderful to see that even though he can see that this body is temporary only, everyone is dying in this material world. He may also have this body, maybe if he is 35 year old, then he may live maybe 35 years more. And if we'll see, then this 35 years are passed just like a flash of lightning. So next 35 years will also cross like that. Even it will cross more early, because then the remaining life, as someone will reach around 60, then anyways bodily problem will start, and then whatever he want to do, he will not be able to do. So, and remaining in 35 years, maybe half of it will be spent in sleeping. That is, a person may sleep for 9-10 hours, then basically half of life is gone. So in that way, we can see that basically like 16 17 years are left with him, and out of that 16 17 years, like the later years, let's suppose 7 or 8 years will be spent because he will not have adequate health so that he can do anything. So now he's left with very 10 years, and out of the 10 years as well office, and then going to office 8 years, 8 hours, and then coming back, and also almost all his life is going to get wasted like this before he can understand that why he is here in this material world, and actually how to come out of this cycle of repeated birth, death, old age, and disease. So with whatever time we have, maybe very little time we have, we should at least try to get little knowledge, whatever is possible with us. Because anyways, with the remaining 10 years that we may be having, out of that 5 years will be spent in just going to office, coming back, and then doing some household activities. So whatever 5 years we can see that are still with us, and that too, there are so many engagements. So at least few hours daily, we can try to extract to for the thing by which we can understand that why we are here in this material and how to come out. And Krishna is ready to provide all the help. He's again and again coming. So when it is not that he only came 5,000 years back, he again came 500 years back as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navdeep Mayapur Dham. And he gave a very easy method. So he gave this method of chanting this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So in earlier ages as well, this chanting was equally effective. But earlier, because there, if someone at the time of chanting is performing some or the other offenses, he's not very attentive, then he's not getting the full result. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in Kali Yuga, he could understand that people are so fallen. So even though if someone is not able to chant properly, not able to hear the mantras properly, but then also he will get the effect and he will come out of this illusion. Because other than, if until and unless it is not with the power of Krishna, no one can come out of this illusion. That's why we all, even though we are hearing these stories again and again, whenever someone is dying, then during the discussion, we heard this story. So one of the story that is being told is this, about this Yaksha talking to Yudhishthira, what is the most wonderful thing? So the one most wonderful thing is that in newspaper, whenever we open the front page, we see so many people are dying, but we are just feeling pity for them. Oh, that person died because this bus toppled over, that person died because of that, that person dies because of heart attack, but we are still trying to live like we are never going to die. And first, the major primary importance thing is that we are not never able to think of this aspect that, okay, whether God has created us and I am here, if someone, because as an Indian, we all understand that our soul is eternal. Okay. Soul never dies. Whenever a person is dying, we all know, at least Indians person know that there is a reincarnation. He will get another body, maybe human body or some animal body. But we don't know that Krishna, when he can create a soul like that soul can never die, whether a body is being burned or whatever is being done, soul remain alive. So can't he be capable to provide us with a body which will also not die? So that is the case that he can provide. And that is there in the spiritual world. In material world, everything is material. In the spiritual world, everything is spiritual. So the planet where we are, accordingly, we will get the body. So if we are in earth planet, so our body is also more of the earthly matters. That is all this calcium, phosphorus, everything. So depending upon the planets, this all is changing. So this all information is given in the scriptures. But we don't have so much time to actually go through all the scripture and understand. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, looking at this fallen condition of this age, has given this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So that one who will sincerely chant this mantra without having any qualification, without going through all the literatures, just having faith on this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, he can understand everything. And then Srila Prabhupada, one of the pure devotees, about his appearance as well, it is already being foretold in many of the scriptures. So Srila Prabhupada appeared and he distributed this Mahamantra freely in the West. And we also get this knowledge because of the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. So among his own associates, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu laughingly said, "I came here to sell my emotional, ecstatic love. Although I came to Varanasi to sell my goods, there were no customer. and it appeared necessary for me to carry them back to my own country. All of you were feeling unhappy that no one was purchasing my goods and that I would have to carry them away. Therefore, by your will only, I have distributed them without charging. So, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he came to distribute this love of Godhead, so even right now, when Prabhupada is distributing this mercy, there are very few takers. Many people, they will say, oh, I don't have any time. I am busy in so many things. So many ignorant think I am just busy in and I am just wasting my life, but I don't have any time for my eternal benefit, how to come out of this cycle of birth and death. But then also it is being distributed freely by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. So earlier as well, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Krishna himself, so he was just giving an example that I am giving it for free. This chanting, there is no cost. We are telling it to everyone. You just chant this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And you will come out of all the ignorance, because spiritual or something religion means that when you practice it, you will realize it that you are coming out of ignorance. So religion means one will develop love of Godhead. Religion means that one will get, so this God realization or self realization goes hand in hand together. So by following a religion, one will automatically realize everything. There is nothing that one has to basically just follow only, and he will not get any realization. He can see things as they are. But to achieve that particular state, one first have to have some faith. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Krishna himself is coming again and again, so he is coming for our all good. So he is giving us free of cost. He is distributing this mercy without any charge. He is telling this secret to everyone. So it is not that any Srila Prabhupada or anyone from ISKCON is charging anything for to tell you that how you can come out of this cycle. But then also, there are only few intelligent people who are coming forward and taking this up. Other people are just thinking that why I should take it, because I have so many enjoyment that I have to do. But they don't know that basically with every setting of day and night, his time span is being reduced by one day. With his every birthday, his time span is getting reduced by 1 year. So without understanding that his time span is very short, he can, within this time span, he can understand everything and he can go back home back to Godhead if he will just chant. But he is not having faith. He is having faith on his own capability. He is thinking that I may work hard and I may make some maybe nice flat. I will have nice family. But they don't understand that whatever anyone, even in the past, people are coming and they are making so many things. But with the due course of time, they all have to leave this body. They also have to leave for the spouses for which they are making this property. They also have to leave for their children also for which they are making it. They also have to leave. So the only good that they can do apart from all these things is to become themselves perfect. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to say that make your own life perfect and do the paropkar, that is make others' life as well perfect. So if you are not being, if someone is a father, someone is a husband, someone is a guru, if he is not able to deliver all the dependent from this repeated cycle of birth and death, then he has no right to become a father or to become a husband. Because father and husband are very responsible position. When someone becomes father, that means the children that he is going to have, he has to ensure that they will again not go into another womb. They will not take birth again. But until unless he is not making his life perfect, how he can deliver his own dependents? So the next is that when we began distributing the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the West countries, so when Srila Prabhupada started it, a similar thing happened. In the beginning, we were very disappointed for at least 1 year because no one came forth to help this woman. So about Srila Prabhupada, we are aware that when he reached West because of the instruction of his spiritual master, so Srila Prabhupada earlier, he tried to his best to give this love of Godhead, this message of Krishna in the country India. But India was so much following West that no one was ready to take. Even our own culture by which we can come out of this ignorance, no one was ready to take because everyone was following West. So then he was preached, he was being instructed by his spiritual master that you should go to West. you should write books and you should preach this in English language to the West, because looking at the Westerner, when they are taking this Krishna consciousness, then Indian people, because they are just following the West, they will also get converted. So Prabhupada, he tried throughout his life. First, he tried that he can basically give this message to Indian people. But when he failed, because no one was taking this in India. So then at that point of time, even though he became almost of 70 years, at the age of 69 years, when everyone will think of retiring or everyone will think of going to Vrindavan and just die, then at that point of time, he started for West without having anything. And in the journey toward the West, he basically have to face two heart attacks, because at that point of time, he was not having any money, only 40 rupees. That is one times, you can understand, meal, one half day cost that is there in US. He was carrying only that much money. And because he cannot manage to get flight tickets or anything, he just got in donation one ticket using a ship, which was known as Jaladuta, which takes so many days, that like more than a month to reach to US, because US is anyways very far. And in between, he suffered seasickness, everything. He suffered two heart attacks. But then also he has full faith that because my spiritual master has instructed me that I should go and try to convert West so that at least Indian people can also get converted. He took all this risk without thinking of his bodily comfort, and he started preaching this message. So for the 1 year, there was no one ready to listen to this message. But then by the grace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, some young boy joined this movement in 1966. Of course, we distributed Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message of Hare Krishna Mahamantra without bargaining or selling. As a result, this movement has spread all over the world with the assistance of European and American boys and girls. We therefore pray for all the blessings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu upon all the devotees in the Western world who are spreading this movement. So before, basically, Sri Namamrita, will just quickly see one clip. You all can hear me?
Yes, Prabhuji.
So I will just show one of the clip. So that will again reiterate this point, that how basically Srila Prabhupada started to the West. So if you all can see it, just let me know.
I can see Prabhuji.
Okay, you all can mute yourself so there will not be echo. You can hear it, right?
Yes, I can see.
But audio is not.
Guruji, audio not at audible.
Yes, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Audio not at audible.
It's not audible to anyone? Hare Krishna, yes, can Prabhu. Anyone other see, other hear of the audio or no one can hear?
No, Prabhu. No, Prabhu. Cannot hear.
Cannot hear, Prabhu.
Not at all.
Yes, Prabhu.
Let me just try some other way. Just give me a moment. Now is it audible?
No, Prabhuji.
Sorry?
No, Prabhuji. Not yet.
Can't hear it. Okay.
Then maybe with this format it may not be possible then maybe to have you all hear the audio. Just let me try one time. Maybe then what I can do is that I will share the links of these videos to you all. So that will be helpful. So in a sense, we can understand that at the age of basically 70 years, when everyone think of retiring in Vrindavan, then at that point of time, he started for West because his spiritual master instructed him to preach in the West. And before that, he tried very hard to give this message in India. So we all have seen that how Prabhupada struggled, that he was, so we'll talk more on it. So, and then in the West, because he distributed this love of Godhead, this Hare Krishna Mahamantra freely, then later when people started experimenting with Hare Krishna Mahamantra, that is, they started following, they put some faith on Srila Prabhupada and they started chanting, then they themselves start seeing that it has an effect. The first effect was that, okay, all those hippie person, those who were not able to control their senses, they're addicted with so many sinful propensities, meat eating, intoxication, illicit sex, gambling. They all just by taking the names of the Lord, because names of the Lord are non-different from the Lord. It is so pure that they all start getting to overcome all those things automatically, because automatically we as a spirit soul are part and parcel of Krishna. You all can hear me now, right?
Yes,
Prabhuji. Yeah. So we all are part and parcel of Krishna. So just by taking the names of the Krishna, our eternal constitutional position is getting revived. Our own spirit soul is eternally, or by its constitutional position, is very pure. And when we take the names of the Lord, we chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then automatically started coming to that original state. And then automatically, when we will come to original state, then automatically we can see that how this all, whether it's illicit sex, whether it is gambling, whether it is intoxication, or whether it is meat eating, this will not further appeal to us. So Prabhupada didn't preach anyone to stop all those things. Just by chanting, they automatically gets higher taste, and with that higher taste, automatically all their senses are got into control, and they can easily quit all those things, just like they were not taking those things. And otherwise, they were also taking intoxication of higher degree, that is, they were taking LSD, marijuana and all, which if someone will become addicted to, then there is no chance that one will be able to leave all those things. But just by this chanting of Hare Krishna mantra, they were able to leave everything. That is, all those higher intoxication, everything. And they all become pure devotees of the Lord. So, we should never underestimate the powers of this chanting of Hare Krishna mantra. We can we should understand that when we are taking the names of the Lord, then we are in association of the Lord. And if we are more and more careful, because when we are chanting the names of the Lord, for us, our name may be different and we may be different. When I am calling Arun Prabhu, then maybe he is different person and his name is different. But for God, everything is absolute. For God, Krishna, he can have his potency in everything. Krishna is present in a spiritual planet at Golok Vrindavan. At the same point of time, he is present in his deities as well. At the same point of time, he is present in his prasadam as well. At the same point of time, he is present in his names as well. And in this age, he has specifically taken this name form. Because earlier he was, when he was coming as Ram, whenever he is coming as Krishna, he has to kill the demons. But in this age, actually this in the age of Kali, all of us are having demonic propensities. So we cannot distinguish that, okay, this person is demon and this person is a devotee. No, everyone in this age, only those people are left who actually have some or the other demonic qualities in them. So it may be that in daily newspaper it is coming that this person has committed this crime, this person has committed rape, this person has committed this. But actually, this all sinful propensities are there in everyone's heart. It is just that maybe some person, because he got that particular propensities higher degree, or he got caught and he is coming into newspapers. Other person are not caught, or is somehow or the other, by the mercy of the Lord, got saved from that particular situation. But the demonic propensities are there in everyone. So Lord, understand this, that in this age, actually there is no need to kill anyone, because everyone is having some or the other demonic propensity. The need is to kill this demonic propensity. And for that purpose, he has given his holy names. If someone will chant it, then automatically he will develop all the saintly qualities. So there is no discrimination that if demon will chant, he will not get. No, whatever a person is, at whatever stage he is, this chanting is so much purifying that anyone who will take to this chanting will become purified. And not only in this age, in earlier age as well, like we are aware that Valmiki, he was earlier known as Ratnakar Daku. And he just took to the names of the chanting, that is, he was chanting the names of the Ram, and he becomes so purified that he could foretell the events. So the Ramayana he has written before the occurrence of Ramayana. So he could see what is going to happen in future, and he was writing it all down. So he becomes such a pure devotee just by taking the names of the Lord. So this name of the Lord, we should not underestimate it. Even though we are chanting it using our material body, which is more or less like a machine only. So we are using our vocal cord and everything, which is more or less like a machine only, but still, this vibration, this holy names, when being chanted with proper faith and with proper attentiveness, then it will transform the heart of a living entity. It will revive their constitutional position. So let's all, if you are having this chant bag with you, you just take it with you and just try to chant it. We'll chant 108 times the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Or if you don't have, then just try to repeat it. You all can unmute yourself and just try to repeat this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So we'll chant one round and then we'll discuss the rest of the session. So before chanting, like, we repeat this Panchatattva Mahamantra, that is, we pray to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and his associates, because we may be still at the time of chanting, so many thoughts may come to our mind. But to avoid all these offenses, we take the names of the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, because they personally appeared 500 years back, just to give this message, this chanting of holy names. And he, because of taking his names, all the offenses are getting nullified. So we'll get some result. So you all can unmute yourself. Satyam Mataji, Arun Prabhu, Rohini Mataji. So just repeat. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya.
Jai Shri Krishna
Chaitanya.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Shri Advaita.
Shri Advaita.
Gadadhara.
Gadadhara.
Shiva Sadi.
Shiva Sadi.
Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare
Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ
ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ
ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ
ಜಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ
ಪ್ರಭು ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ
ಪ್ರಭು ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ
ಶ್ರೀ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಗದಾಧರ
ಶ್ರೀ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಗದಾಧರ
ಶಿವ ಸಾಧಿ ಗೌರ ಭಕ್ತವೃಂದ
ಶಿವ ಸಾಧಿ ಗೌರ ಭಕ್ತವೃಂದ
ಸರಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ
ಹರಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ
ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಮಹಾಮಂತ್ರ ಇನ್ ನಾಮಾಮೃತ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ we all know that we are all spirit soul part and parcel of Krishna. We are all a spiritual spark, but when we come to this material world, so we are all covered with so much of illusion, which is just like a spark. When there is so much of smoke, then one cannot see any spark. But if the smoke will be fanned, if someone will fan the smoke, then again the blazing fire will start. So same is the process of this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, that even though this all knowledge we are trying to give, but until and unless you are not receiving it and absorbing it in your soul, it is not of any benefit. And just so that some layering of all this illusion which has covered a human being should be cleared off. And for that purpose, we'll chant this one round of Hare Krishna Mahamantra so that we can get some spiritual strength, some spiritual potency, so that we can understand these subject matters. So you all can see my screens?
Yes, Prabhuji.
So basically in Bhakti Vriksha, when we do it face to face, then we basically play some of the videos on the life and the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. But in this Skype session, as I can see that same was not possible, you all was not able to hear any audio. So I will share that as in basically home background work or as in homework to all of you to listen to those recordings over the weeks, whatever I will share. So you will get more and more understanding of Srila Prabhupada and about his contribution in giving us this Krishna consciousness, which is of the prime importance to everyone. So when something is called a religion, that means it is eternal. So, and it is universal. That is, it will not only act on basically Indians, but it will act on everyone, because God is one, Krishna for everyone. And if anyone, whether he is Indian, whether he is Western, he will take these holy names, his heart will get purified and he can understand his relationship with Krishna and how he has covered in this bodily concept of life, thinking himself as an Indian, Australian or American. But he's all of us are part and parcel of Krishna, because being born in different families, different culture, we become too much entangled and we think we are just part of it. So very simple example is that when we take birth in a particular family, we consider our parents as everything. We don't know that these parents also we have to change after leaving this body. Again, we'll get a new set of parents, maybe in human origin or maybe in animal kingdom. We'll get some parents for sure, because until unless we are not going back home, back to Godhead, we are still in this world, in this material world. And whatever spouses that we have, we think that, okay, we are marrying them, then we are going to have our relationship for the next 7 births. No, nothing like that. In some situation, if both are very attached and they are dying together, then there are chances that, okay, husband, because when he's dying, he's only thinking of his wife. Wife, when she's dying, she's only thinking of husband. And then they both die together. Because of the attachment and the karmic reaction, they may take again birth. Wife will become husband and husband will become wife, and they will again may marry in the next birth. And this may continue. But most of the time we see that maybe husband may die early or wife may die early, and then accordingly they may take birth. Not sure, not only in human origin, they may take, someone will take in animal kingdom, someone will take in another animal kingdom. So there is no point that both can be together again in another birth or maybe in 7 births. So one should come out of all this illusion which is binding it. And the only thing that they can do for their spouse, their parents and their family members is to first to make their own life perfect. Because if they will have this perfect vision, then they can try to deliver their dependent as well. Otherwise, there is no use. Whatever we are doing is on just the bodily platform. And it is not different from what animals are doing. Animals are also sleeping, eating, mating and defending. And you are also just giving the comforts to your family member, which are all pertaining to sophisticated sleeping, sophisticated eating, sophisticated mating, or sophisticated, basically, defending. That is, you provide, defend means you want to have defense from all the external factor. You provide them with home only, which even animals are also having. A mouse may dig a simple hole in the mud, so mouse, and will provide that to the she mouse. Same we are doing, we'll provide them with a pigeon house, some flat, basically eating. So birds are also collecting food stuff for their baby birds. We are also doing those things, and same thing, sophisticated sleeping, sophisticated mating. So whatever animal are doing, we are also providing to our family member. Then we are not doing anything different from the animal. The only thing that we can do it differently is to understand our position in this material world and how to come out of the cycle of repeated birth and death, and similarly to help them also. Because if we'll keep Krishna in the center of all our activities, then definitely we can still be so much loving to all our family members, all our basically nears and dears one, and we can make Krishna in the center so that they will also make spiritual progress and they will also get out of this repeated cycle of birth and death, and they can also go back home, back to God. So today's topic is on Srila Prabhupada's perfect gift to the world. So all this knowledge Prabhupada has given, one pure devotee, if he want, he can deliver everyone. So Prabhupada, he was one pure devotee who has given this knowledge to all of us, and he has given this, all these books that are written by Srila Prabhupada, even when he is not here physically, he is not present, but we can get the benefit by reading all those books. So we all understand that at the time of Rup Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Narottam Das Thakur and all, that is 500 years back. When they were doing this book distribution, at that point of time, the book writing these books were very difficult. One has to basically engage professional writer, and they will basically using their own pen, that is basically the feather of some bird and the ink, they are just writing all those things by their hand. So producing books were very difficult. In writing one or two books, it requires years and years of efforts. Because Srimad Bhagavatam, there are so many verses. 18,000 verses. So writing Bhagavad Gita, so many verses, so many explanation. So just to create some books, it was taking so much of effort. So Narottam Das Thakur at 500 years back, he was lamenting that right now, even though we want to do book distribution, but we are unsuccessful. But in future, one devotee will appear who will use all this modern technology and he will make this book distribution very much easy. And everyone will have access to this transcendental teachings. So it is already recorded in one of the palm leaves that what he has been told and that thing, what he has predicted, Srila Prabhupada has fulfilled it. Srila Prabhupada appeared, and even though being a pure devotee, he employed everything, all the technologies in the service of Krishna, because that is the real aim. When sometimes people are saying that devotional service or being spiritual means you renounce everything material, but that is not real understanding. You can employ each and everything in service to Krishna. So like we are doing, we are all gathering here using a Skype-based method, which is all product of technology. But if technology is utilized in service to Krishna, then that is the best use of technology. So Srila Prabhupada, using all the technology, he has provided us with all these books, which are available to all of us to go through and understand our real position. So by chanting as well, we can realize our real position. But by chanting and realizing our real position, that may take some years. And you should be faithful to the chanting. But in parallelly, if you are reading Srila Prabhupada's book, then also you are coming out of illusion. Being in association with the books that are written by Srila Prabhupada, that are being told by Krishna. So Prabhupada, the basically uniqueness of Srila Prabhupada's books are that these are written as it is, that is without any change. Whatever Krishna is speaking, the same thing is there in these books. So they are having the pure potency, and these books are coming in disciplic succession. Like Srila Prabhupada, like Krishna told this message to Vyasadeva, to Narad, so to Brahma, from Brahma to Narad, from Narad to Vyasadeva. So in that way, from Vyasadeva to Madhvacharya, so in this way, this all knowledge is coming down. So that's why we are all called Brahma Gaudiya Madhava Sampradaya. So that is Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya. That is, this is coming, this knowledge is coming directly from Krishna to Brahma to Vyas, to, so in disciplic succession to Vyasadeva, Madhvacharya, all those personalities which are all eternal servants of Krishna. So Madhvacharya was non different than Hanuman himself, who appeared in this disciplic succession. Brahma we all know, Narad we all know, and so many in all the sampradayas, all the empowered personalities, all the basically associates of the Lord. So like Sri Ramanujacharya, we know, is non-different than the brother of Lord, that is Lakshman himself or Anansesh. So all of these personalities, they are coming as a spiritual master and giving us this message. And about Srila Prabhupada as well, it is being foretold. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he appeared, Krishna himself 500 years back, he told that in coming time, those people who just to avoid these teachings will run away to the west, then I will send my Senapati Bhakta. And then he will go even to the west and he will deliver this message. So Srila Prabhupada, he basically appeared in this material world and then he preached this message even to the west, so that they are also getting delivered. Now we have thousands and thousands of ISKCON temple throughout the whole world, and they are all getting benefited. They are all coming out of this bodily concept of illusion. So we are also fortunate to have Srila Prabhupada as our guide and shelter. Srila Prabhupada is the direct initiating and instructing a spiritual master for his disciples and for their disciple. He is their grandfather, a spiritual master or Param Guru. So right now Prabhupada is no more here with his physical body, but he is still the instructing spiritual master for even us, that is disciples of their disciples, or those who are trying to be his disciples. So how he is still instructing us? Because his books are all available with all of us. Whenever we are in doubt, we can go through his Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, and we can get the direction how to progress back to this path. So he is a grandfather, spiritual master, or a Param Guru. In addition, Srila Prabhupada, as the founder Acharya of ISKCON, is the primary instructing spiritual master and shelter for all ISKCON members. In 1994, the GBC tries to define Srila Prabhupada's position as founder Acharya of ISKCON. So we all have seen that earlier, all these spiritual masters, all the basically devotees in this disciplic succession, they are preaching this message. So we have this basically four sampradayas. So this one is our Brahma sampradaya. Then we have sampradayas by four kumaras. Okay, we have Nimbarak sampradaya. So we have different sampradayas, but basically Prabhupada came and he established this ISKCON, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also appeared in this basically Brahmado Gaudiya Sampradaya, and it is being foretold that later all these four sampradayas will also merge into it, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he could understand that in this age people are so fallen that just by chanting only, just having full faith on chanting, they can be delivered, chanting of this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So then later on, all the other four sampradayas will also merge into it, and all will take to this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And for that purpose, Srila Prabhupada has established ISKCON. So before that as well, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Maharaj, who was his spiritual master, he established Gaudiya Math. But actually, most of his disciples, they didn't follow the real teachings that are given by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, where he requested everyone to cooperate. So then Prabhupada has to establish his ISKCON, and basically we all have to now cooperate. So it is not that one man preaching. So this session is also called Bhakti Vriksha, because we expect you all to become perfect, you all to understand it yourself. And when you will understand it yourself, you will feel it very compassionate on other souls as well, and you want to deliver this message to others as well. And this way you all cooperatively will try to deliver this message, working under the shelter of ISKCON, and then everyone throughout the whole world will be delivered. Because as per Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has already basically predicted that in upcoming 10,000 years, golden age will come. That is, everyone will start following the philosophies of Krishna consciousness, or majority of the world will start to follow Krishna consciousness. So to have this 10,000 years of golden period as predicted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we all have to put our own effort. Definitely, if it is being predicted by Lord himself, then this is bound to come. You all will automatically, as you will start to practice this, you all will automatically get the empowerment. But you all have to put your own effort. That is, you have to chant these holy names purely and properly. And then you yourself will come to your own original constitutional position. And within this lifetime, you can see everything on your own eyes. So religion means you will be able to see everything from your own eyes. And then you can start deliver it to everyone. And before, even if you're not getting the all realization, but you know, if you have the faith that this is the right path, you can start giving to everyone. And Krishna become very much pleased if someone is trying to preach this philosophy to others. And then automatically he will reveal himself to others. So to fulfill the previous Acharya's desire for a united worldwide preaching organization, to expand Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission, Sri Prabhupada founded the International Society for Krishna Consciousness as a distinct branch of Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. Therefore, he is the founder Acharya of ISKCON. Srila Prabhupada is the foundational Siksha Guru for all the ISKCON devotees, because he has realized and presented the teachings of the previous Acharyas of the Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya appropriately for the modern age. So Srila Prabhupada, his biggest contribution is his books, because when you read his books, apart from the basically translation from the Sanskrit verses to the English text, he has also provided his purport. And once someone will go to his purport, to all each of these scriptures, then he will find those purport very much adopted to the present modern age. Because in the current age, people will not be able to understand the real message of Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita. But additionally, Prabhupada has given this purport so that how to apply it in the present modern age. So if anyone will go through it, even currently, practically, they can apply this spiritual knowledge in their life, and they will be benefited, and they will be able to benefit others as well. So Srila Prabhupada's instruction are essential teaching for every ISKCON devotees. Srila Prabhupada's books are embodiment of his teaching and should be accepted as the standard by all future generation of ISKCONs. So why he has done, why we are saying that his teaching should be accepted as standard by all future generation of ISKCON? Because we know Srila Prabhupada was an empowered devotee who has been predicted in his scriptures that he will come and give this message. And all the teachings he has recorded in his books. So if someone will even follow his books, then he will be free from any of the deviation. Because in future, we are not sure. Maya is very strong. Someone may come and they may little bit deviate here and there from his teachings. But if someone is using Srila Prabhupada's books as a law book, then they can correct their own basically deviations. Because until and unless one is not a pure devotee, when one is a pure devotee, then whatever is written in all the scriptures will be automatically revealed to him from inside, from his heart. But till the time he has not become pure, there are chances that he may deviate from his path, because illusion is so strong that illusion may make him think that maybe he can recommend something and maybe that will also help others. But he may deviate from his path. And just to avoid all this deviation, because this movement has to go on, this golden age will come in the next 10,000 years. Okay. So we have to accept his books as a standard. Okay. And then we have to correct all the deviations. So all the devotees, all of us as well, even those who are not preaching, they can themselves see at what level they are by going through his books. And they can correct their own behavior. They can at least understand what is right and wrong. Doing right and wrong first means that you should know what is right. So people are saying that they can do good. But Prabhupada used to say to do good, one should know what is good. If they don't know what is good, then they may be doing wrong and they don't understand it. There are so many examples. People open orphanages or old age homes and they started feeding non-vegetarian food stuff to all those orphans or all those old people. But actually, they are again implicating in law of karmas, because by eating non-vegetarian food stuff, they are themselves basically incurring sins. They are making others to incur more and more sins, and then they have to suffer because of that. So to actually do good to other, one should understand that what is good. And to understand it, one should go through the Srila Prabhupada book. Because these law of karmas are like that it is just like a candle. If candle is burning, even if a child will put also the... When the people are having suffering, they question God, oh God, I am so pious, I have not done anything wrong, then why I am suffering? But God has provided all his law books, all his books that Srila Prabhupada has basically even explained on each and every book. So Prabhupada has done hundreds of books. One of the book is like Law of Karma. So there he has already explained that Krishna is saying that if you involved into these sinful activities, then you will incur reaction. You will have reaction. Because if you are giving suffering to some other living entity, then you are bound to suffer. And that's why Prabhupada wanted us to free from all the suffering, because he cannot see all of us suffering. So that's why he has given the message of the Lord, which is very much adept for the current age. And if someone will read it, at least following it may require some spiritual strength, which can be generated by chanting of the holy name. At least they should know that what is right, what is wrong, and then they should act in their life. So Srila Prabhupada should be worshipped daily by every ISKCON member. So one should offer in Mangal Aarti, one should offer prayers to Srila Prabhupada, everyone. So just by offering prayers to the Acharyas, our prayers are directly reaching to Krishna. Because it is coming in disciplic section, if someone is worshipping, someone is basically giving respect to the Guru, then automatically it is being foretold, it is given in scripture. If someone has firm faith in a spiritual master, and firm faith on Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, then without having him any qualification, even if he don't know anything, all the knowledge will be revealed from within, because the soul is having all knowledgeable. Satchit Anand, that is eternal, full of knowledge. So this full of knowledge is there in the soul. Soul will automatically reveal it, and you will get all the knowledge. But one should have firm faith on a spiritual master. That's why we should worship him daily. Every ISKCON spiritual master is responsible to guide his disciple to follow Srila Prabhupada's instruction. Even all the basically disciples of Srila Prabhupada who has taken the role of initiating a spiritual master are responsible to guide his disciples to follow Srila Prabhupada's instruction. As founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada gave direction for management, principle of cooperation, and other practical guideline which form the basis and inspiration for all ISKCON policies. So Prabhupada has given actually everything in his book, how to manage it. So he has like told that, okay, we have to to we have to avoid all the deviations. He has made a governing body commission so that there will be a management pillar also to everything, so that if there are any deviation, anything which need to be corrected, so management can take decision and they can basically everyone can adopt it. How we all should cooperate. One should not think that one single-handedly will be able to deliver this message throughout the whole world. That is one of the biggest illusion. We need cooperation. Even if one's a spiritual master, he want to propagate this message, he has to accept thousands and thousands of disciples, so that all those disciples will make a collective force and they will be able to fight with Maya. They will be able to deliver this message, because in this material world, like we told, this material world is called the superintendent deities, or the basically the presiding deity of this material world is Durga. Durga means jail and Durga means superintendent of jail. So definitely if someone wants to come out of this, then she will pose some disturbance. And this age is also Kali Yuga. So the king Kali, it will never allow people to actually come out of illusion. Because in this age, even though one wants to be pious, but automatically the propensity is to do more and more sin. Even if someone don't want to indulge into illicit sex, but automatically he is being forced to perform illicit sex. So why all these things are happening? Because this age is called Kali Yuga. Automatically, just being in touch with this material atmosphere, you will become more and more contaminated. That's why we are recommended to daily chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, so that we can daily clean ourselves out. If someone is not daily chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra 16 times, that is 16 rounds, then definitely he will not be able to free from these clutches. But I'm not saying that you all can come to the 16 round from the very start, but at least try to, whatever state you are in, try to take, try to begin from that and try to increase. If you're not chanting at all, you start to try chanting daily one round of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. If you're chanting one round, try to do it two round. If you're doing it two round, you can try to do it four round. Then automatically you will get, people may say that they don't have any time, but automatically you will become more and more efficient, because we all are having a spiritual force. Because of being covered with so much of material ignorance, we are losing all those spiritual force, and because of that we are so dull. We cannot do even our own activities. We cannot even wake up. So, but if we'll just chant, then automatically our spiritual force will get awakened, and then we can, if more, with more and more spiritual force, we can progress from two round to four round, four round to six rounds. So, but at least we should start. So Prabhupada has given everything, his management principle of cooperation and other practical guideline in all his books, which form the basis and inspiration for ISKCON policies. Srila Prabhupada established the governing body commission to execute his will following the order of the previous acharyas. So basically we all can understand that basically some management pillar is also needed, because once a spiritual master is gone, his disciples are there, then we don't know. Maybe some disciples may get influenced by the forces of material energy, by the forces of Kali, and may deviate. So there is a governing body commission who has to foresee, or who has to see actually, that everything is going on properly. Whatever Prabhupada has instructed, that things are going on properly. So there is a GBC body which has been made. So all the pure devotees, and that is also not a body made up of one person, because one person may get illusion. So it is a body where so many sannyasis or basically pure devotees are being working together to see that there are no deviation from this path. Because if there is any deviation, then definitely there will be havoc. Then people will not be able to progress. So Srila Prabhupada, after realizing the teachings of the previous acharyas, gave his follower the completely balanced and authorized system for practicing Krishna consciousness. The system that is timeless and eternal, as well as appropriate for today's world. So you might be surprised to know that till the time of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Maharaj, that is his spiritual master, one has to chant 64 rounds daily. And then Prabhupada, when he could understand that it is not possible, for so people are so fallen, and this message has to be delivered to West as well, and here as well, people don't have that much strength or neither that much time to chant 64 rounds, because that may take 8 hours. So one cannot give that much time for his self-realization, because the realization may come very late. So they may not be able to even ready to spend that much time. So Prabhupada, because he was empowered by Krishna, he reduced that chanting from 64 round to just 16 round, which can be easily completed within 1.5 hours. So right now you may be taking 2 hours or so, but gradually as you will be able to focus more and more on the holy names, you will be able to finish it off in 1.5 hours or maximum by 2 hours. So Prabhupada has reduced it. So he has made it very much practical for the current age. So 2 hours, anyone in the morning, automatically by chanting, they will get spiritual strength. They can rise up in the morning. They can do deity worship. They can do chanting and they can go back home back to God. So he has made it very practical. So the system that is timeless and eternal as well as appropriate for today's world. Srila Prabhupada knew the need of his followers as well as need of the people of the world. His gift of Krishna consciousness is the perfect and priceless gift for all of us, for the world. And for the world, by assisting Srila Prabhupada and his representative in disseminating the Sankirtan movement of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one become blessed and the fallen soul of the worlds get the inconceivable mercy of Krishna consciousness. Everyone should very carefully study the books and teaching of his divine grace Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada so that they can continue the great legacy of Krishna consciousness that Srila Prabhupada has given to the world. So now we discussed that now we have so much little time to left with us. And rather than just wasting it in sleeping, we can at least try to take out at least 1 hour a day for us for to come out of this. At least is to start with 1 hour. So Prabhupada has given everything. We try to basically chant one of the things that he has given and try to read his book. If someone is just starting, he can give just 30 minutes to chanting. He may be able to chant, let's suppose, 4 rounds and 30 minutes to reading his book. And then automatically he will get more and more realization and he can basically advance from that particular position. And if someone is trying to help Srila Prabhupada and his representative in disseminating this Sankirtan movement, so how you all can help is just by understanding this knowledge and try to give it to others. Because whenever some living entity will fall into this material world, automatically he will covered with so much of illusion, 5 kinds of illusion. Tamisra, Andha Tamisra, by which he is just, even though if he will go to temple as well, he'll just pray to the Lord, "Oh Lord, let me not get diseased. Oh Lord, maybe whatever my kid's disease will get cured." So they don't know that even though if we are going to temple, these all, whatever material we are praying, let's suppose to our body or their bodies or our near and dear one's body, our body is not going to stay. So one should not go only to the Lord just to ask for some bodily comfort, because by the very law of nature, we understand this body is anyways going to perish. So how we can pray for all these things? If we have to pray, we have to pray that how I can, even though whatever state I'm in, how to come out of this cycle of birth and death. So basically, when you get this knowledge, you have to try to give it to others as well, because they are covered with so much of illusion that they don't know. They think that the purpose of religion is only to get some comfort in this material life, in this material body, but they don't know that all the benediction, even if they will get from demigods, then if they are pertaining to this material body is anyways going to get finished in this lifetime. Even though they may pray for some wealth, but wealth also, they will not be able to take any wealth. They will be finished. This all wealth, whatever flat, land, whatever they are trying to accumulate, that will stay here. But because of being illusion, people are being forced, because everyone is illusion. They will take so much of home loan, everything, just to get some little space. And then finally, they cannot take anything. They suffer throughout their life just to pay the EMIs, or to just maintain some bank balance, and then they die without working on themselves. And when they are dying with so much of sins accumulated, then they will go to the lower regions. That is, they may take birth in the animal families, and then they become completely covered. So the best utilization of human life is just to understand this, and you understand yourself, you become pure, and you try to give it to the others, to the all the fallen souls of the world who are so much covered because of this illusion. So the personality of Kali is certainly extremely upset by Srila Prabhupada implanting and spreading Krishna consciousness all over the world. King Kali will try to do anything in his power to put obstacle in front of the Krishna conscious movement progress. So when we talk about King Kali or when we talk about Durga, people become very much bewildered. They think, oh, this all is not possible. This all is science. Everything is science. But even the scientists, the great, great scientists, they are saying that this material world, when we see so much order in this material world, we understand there is some intelligence behind it. Because intelligence create orderness. And if there is no intelligence, then it create randomness. So just looking at the order of this material world, that everything, this earth is rotating in its orbit around the sun. If it will become little close to the sun, it will completely get fired. And if it will become little far, then there will be complete ice. So everything is perfect. There is oxygen, there is everything, water for our drinking. There are trees which are producing oxygen. So everything is there. There is a complete order in everything. So this order cannot be without any intelligence. So even the scientists, even though they cannot see, they accept that there must be some intelligence. And if someone will follow this Krishna consciousness, they will chant properly, then they can understand. By this chanting, when they come out of ignorance, then they understand that in reality, there is a Durga Devi who is actually, who is controlling everyone, who is keeping everyone in illusion. All these, even the big scientists, philosopher, even though they are under illusion, they may be thinking, oh, we are working for a very good sake. We may be working in an NGO. We are trying to help people, but they are not able to help anyone. Because they are being covered, until and unless one will not surrender to Krishna, they will not be freed from this illusion. Because only if Krishna will order this material energy, because whether it is Durga, they are all just servant, or they are all just devotees of Krishna. If Krishna will order them, that you free this particular soul, then only we can be free from all this illusion. So we become very much surprised that, oh, this material world is governed by Durga. We think that, oh, scientists are doing so many things. No, this is a fact, but one cannot see it until and unless he is not properly performing his devotional service. But for the time being, one should have full faith and to understand that whatever scripture is giving is 100% correct. People, all these scientists, they are just making some or the other hypothesis and assumption. They are giving something or the other which are nothing but their own mind concoctions. Sometimes some scientists will give something and over the period of time that will be failure. Another scientist will give something else. So rather than blindly following each and everything, one should understand that what is the reality which is given in all the scriptures. So the scriptures are also telling that this is the age of Kali and the personality of Kali, that is the most contaminated age. But the only good advantage is in this age is that just by chanting, one can come out of this influence of all this Kali Yuga. But this Kali Yuga, this personality of Kali, so is extremely upset by Srila Prabhupada implanting and spreading Krishna consciousness all over the world. So King Kali will try to do anything in his power to put obstacle in front of the Krishna conscious movement's progress. So many times, so individually, we will be tested in varieties of ways. So many times, like we see, that, oh, once someone will come to Krishna consciousness, they cannot progress. After attending maybe one session or two sessions, they will not be able to join again. Why? Because Kali and this Durga Devi, she will understand, oh, this person is not very much sincere. Let me put some obstacle and he will just run away. And he will again come into this cycle of birth and death and can remain here. And that why people will become covered in so many illusions. And they will not be able to come out. But one should not fail in these tests. So collectively, the test will also be in the form of various attempts to block our progress or deviate us from Srila Prabhupada path. We should remain firmly under the center of Srila Prabhupada and in that way cling strongly to the lotus feet of Lord Shishi Gaurnitai. So there are every day we may get some or the other allurement. You do this, your life will be successful. You do this training, you do this course, you will do this, that, and we are just wasting our human form of life. You do this business, that business, and we are just wasting our life. So this all are just attempt of Kali and Durga Devi just to see. If you are not sincere, let me waste your human form of life and then next birth, see you in the animal form or in the tree form. And in the tree form, you may be standing for 500 or 1,000 years and I'll let you suffer because you didn't, you are not sincere. You didn't, even though you get this path, you didn't take it seriously. And you just made your own path and you just progress onto it and then it end with your death and again birth in some or the other lower form of life. So one should, when he get it, he should try to just follow it and he should try to progress in this path and then see it for themselves. So this is not that one, we are saying it and one cannot feel it. If you will follow it, you can just see it. If someone will chant, automatically he will see that he has no more desire for illicit sex, intoxication, gambling, meat eating. How is it that possible? So just by having the experiment of this chanting of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, at least one can feel there is a presence of Krishna. why when he is chanting, taking, he is doing so much gossiping throughout day, he is speaking something or the other, but there is no effect. But when he will chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, there is so much of effect. So by this only, by the Shabd Praman, one can understand that there is God, there is a Krishna. Just taking his holy names is making me so much pure. So let me progress in this path and see by myself. So preaching is the essence, we'll read, and then there is one more handout that we'll read. So quickly I will read. Preaching is the essence. Lord Chaitanya's prediction that Krishna consciousness will spread all over the world is being realized. You all can see my screen, right? Pragati Mataji, you can see my screen?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yes, yes.
Pragati Mataji? Piyushir. Piyush, can you read it?
We can read it, yes.
Yes. Can you read it loudly? Piyush.
Hello? Hare Krishna?
You can read it. Yes, I can hear you. You can read it loudly?
Yes.
Please read it.
Preaching is the essence. Lord Chaitanya's prediction that Krishna consciousness will spread all over the world is being realized. When people came to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to discuss the principles of various scriptures, the Lord defeated their false conclusion and established the predominance of devotional service to the Lord. With logic and argument, he very politely changed their mind. We have been spreading the Sankirtana movement in the Western countries, and in our recent tour of European cities like Rome, Geneva, Paris, Frankfurt, many learned Christian scholars, priests, philosophers and yogis came to see us, and by the grace of Krishna, they agreed that this Krishna consciousness movement, the Bhakti cult, offers the topmost conclusion. Following the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are trying to convince everyone that the devotional service of the Lord is enjoyed in every scripture. It is not the question of being Christian, Mohammedan or Hindu. One should be purely religious and freed from all these material designations. This argument appeals to all the intelligent men, and consequently this Krishna consciousness movement is gaining ground throughout the world. Due to our solid logic and scientific presentation, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prediction that Krishna consciousness will spread in every town and village throughout the world is gradually being realized.
Yes, thanks. Thanks, Pish.
Thank you.
So, even at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, people were very much confused that which is the path that one has to follow. Some people are thinking that, oh, they will follow the Varnashram Dharma, that is, will first have Brahmacharya, then Grahasthas, then maybe later Sannyasas, and then Vanaprastha and Sannyas. And if they will just follow their Varnashram Dharma, they will realize God. So, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he basically provided that the real aim of this religion is not to go for get the artha, kama, moksha. No, the real aim of religion is to get love of Godhead. So when someone will love God, then automatically, if someone is able to love God, then that is the fulfillment of everything. Because God is also person. We are all coming from the spiritual world. We were all having loving relationship with Krishna. And that is the eternal position that we all again have to achieve to go back home, back to God. So it is not that one with having some still not loving Krishna. So it is very natural. So if someone is your father, you naturally will love your father. So we are all having this supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna is our father. He is the seed giving father. He is told in Bhagavad Gita that all these living entities, the seed giving father is me. So even though scientists, they may be trying, they may be doing so many of experiment, they are mixing amino acid and they are doing some electricity, lighting, but they are not able to produce any life form, because Krishna is telling that lives come from life, or life is coming from me. So we all are part and parcel of Krishna. We are all son and servant of Krishna. So naturally, if someone is son of Krishna, then he will love his father. So when there is a small kid, when he will get some pocket money from his father, and from that pocket money, he will purchase some small gift and he will give to God. He will give to his father. Father will be very much pleased. So our relationship with Krishna is just like that. Krishna is giving us everything, all the food, all the air, all the oxygen. No one has manufactured it. Krishna is providing by his arrangement. Trees are giving us oxygen. Trees are giving us all the food materials. No one in the factories cannot produce any cereals, any food grains. No food items can be produced in factories. It is only being provided by Krishna, by Mother Nature. So if we, for example, before taking our food, if we prepared food without onion, garlic, vegetarian food, and offer it to Krishna, then he will accept it as a loving offering from his son, and he will accept it. And then if we'll take that food, it will become prasadam. We also will get nourished. We also will get more and more spiritual potency. So that way, so the similar relationship that we should ideally have with our father, the same relationship Krishna is expecting, because he is Supreme Father. So when we will have love of Godhead, when we will really love someone, then we will automatically think of that particular person. We think that how we can please him, how we can actually go back to him. How, because all of us are son and servant of Krishna, how others can also go back to him. So in that way, it is very much practical. And if someone will basically purely chant, someone will read the books, someone will do deity worship in the morning, someone will properly follow it. If someone will simply chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra properly, then he will realize everything. So that's why this Lord Chaitanya has predicted this Krishna consciousness movement will spread all, throughout the whole world. And this is getting realized because it is irrespective of if someone is having Western body, foreign body. But then also because Krishna is one, he's Supreme Father for everyone. In all the other religion, we are not getting the full information. So Jesus Christ is telling that he's basically son of God. Prophet Muhammad is saying he was servant of God. But if some in another religion, if someone will ask who is God, how he looks like, then it is being told it is a supreme secret. But that supreme secret is clarified here in our Indian scriptures, in our Vedic scriptures. So it is everything about Krishna, the supreme God, is being told how he looks like. Everything, whatever, what activities he is doing, everything is being told. And if someone, and he is again and again coming, he has given this message just 500 years back again. The same message of Bhagavad Gita he has again given. And to achieve it, he has given this chanting of Hare Krishna Mantra. If anyone will chant, they can understand themselves and they can progress on this path. So that's why this is automatically being progressing to the whole world. So these statement of the GBC on the position of Srila Prabhupada, anyone would like to read right now, or they want to, if they want to drop off, then I can basically give it to them and they can read it offline. What do you all suggest? You want me to read it? Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhuji.
I can read it?
Yes,
Prabhu. So a statement of GBC of the ISKCON adopted March 9, 2013. So this is from one of the papers. As the founder acharya of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, that is CON, and the preeminent teacher and the ultimate authority within our society, Srila Prabhupada has a unique relationship with every ISKCON devotee, because we all come with Krishna in Krishna consciousness because of his books only. We get more and more realization because of his books. So we all have a unique relationship with Srila Prabhupada. Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is the original Guru whose divine grace descend through the medium of the Guru Parampara. As such, a devotee is ultimately delivered by Krishna, acting through a combination of various manifestations of his mercy. These include, but are not limited to, Chaitya Guru, that is from within. So one is having soul and super soul also. That is, super soul, which is expansion of Krishna, is inside each and every one of us. Because Krishna, being Supreme Father, is waiting all of us to turn toward him. So that's why he is sitting in all of us as in super soul. And as soon, whenever we try to go to Krishna, automatically he will give us the right direction. When we hear this message, then he is the approver. He will approve this message that you are listening to is a correct message. You should follow it. So he is acting as a Chaitya Guru from inside. And then Srila Prabhupada, who has given it externally, all these books, the Guru Parampara, and once Diksha Guru, other Sikshas Gurus, the holy name, Shastras, and the 9 process of devotional services, starting from hearing, chanting. So all these things are acting for delivering one. So for one to go back to Godhead, all these things are acting. Srila Prabhupada is also acting, initiating a spiritual master and a Shiksha Guru. So many devotees, they are giving you the right instructions so that you all can go. Everyone is giving this. The holy names, this chanting, all of them are helping. And one of, and basically Srila Prabhupada is also one of the greatest contribution from all of these forces which are helping you to go back. So within these cooperative elements, Srila Prabhupada is the founder acharya of International Society of Krishna Consciousness, is the preeminent guru for all members of ISKCON. All members of ISKCON for all generation are encouraged to seek shelter of Srila Prabhupada. All members of ISKCON are entitled and encouraged to have personal relationship with Srila Prabhupada through his books, teachings, service and his ISKCON society. All members accepting leadership roles within ISKCON, including Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, have the duty of serving together under ISKCON Governing Body Commission and to fulfill Srila Prabhupada's instruction as he has given in his books, lecture and personal communications. Overall, the primary duty of all Diksha Guru, Siksha Guru and others in leadership position is to assist Srila Prabhupada in his service to his Guru Maharaj Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur and our Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya. Those who accept the service of Diksha Guru or Siksha Guru in ISKCON are required to be exemplary in representing the Prabhupada teaching in their words and personal behavior. The Siksha Guru gives spiritual instruction and inspiration on behalf of Srila Prabhupada. The Diksha Guru gives spiritual instruction, inspiration, formal initiation, a spiritual name and later impart the sacred Gayatri Mantra to a qualified disciple as a service to Srila Prabhupada and our Guru Parampara. So one should try to follow. So even if someone is acting as a Siksha Guru, one is preaching this message to other, they should also try to follow this themselves. They should also have some realization and they also should be preaching it to others. So if they will be following the teachings of Srila Prabhupada purely, the more spiritual force they will automatically get, because Krishna will act as a Chaitya Guru and he will be able to reveal the Krishna consciousness to others as well. But one should also try to become more and more pure, then he will be able to give this message to others. So Srila Prabhupada has clearly explained that devotees who are strictly following the Krishna conscious principle are acting on the liberated platform and as such are pure devotees, even though they may actually not yet be liberated. Such unalloyed devotional service is not necessarily determined by one's role or position of service but by one's realization. So if you are acting in Krishna consciousness, even though you may be not a Siksha Guru, Diksha Guru, but if you are pure, then automatically you will get more and more realization. And then you are giving it to others, you are acting on a liberated platform. So even though you may not be liberated, you have not basically gone back to Godhead, or you have not become a pure devotee, or you may not have achieved love of God, but to the level you are following these Krishna conscious principle, the level you will get more and more realization, and the more and more basically you will be able to give this message to others purely. So those who accept the service of Diksha or Siksha Guru within ISKCON are mandated to be strict follower of the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. And as long as they follow, they are acting on the liberated platform. Thus, they may serve as Srila Prabhupada ordered as bona fide representative of the Lord and the Guru Parampara and be the via medium of their mercy. Yet it should be clearly understood that if such Diksha or Siksha Guru deviate from strictly following, they may fall down from their position. So one should understand that initiating a spiritual master may be either eternally perfected, that is Nitya Siddha, or he may be Sadhana Siddha, that is, he will, by performing purely chanting, following all the regulative principle, by performing pure sadhana, he may get liberated. Or third thing is, basically, even if he may not be eternally perfected, or third thing is like Kripa, or mercy of instruction is initiating a spiritual master, or by the mercy of a spiritual master, he may become perfect. And the fourth thing is that, even though he may not be perfect, but to the level he is following his spiritual master, to the level he is following the teachings in a pure way and he is giving the teachings to the other in a pure way, till that state he is liberated. So one can even then also act as an initiating spiritual master even. That is, even act as a Diksha Guru if he is strictly following whatever Prabhupada has given, whatever is given in a bona fide disciplic succession. If he is not speaking anything beyond the subject matter which is already given by Prabhupada or the previous acharyas, because they were all liberated soul, if he is just giving that as to that level, he is also pure, and then he can deliver others as well, even though he may not be liberated or he may not be completely pure devotee. So in that way, this movement, even though someone may not be pure at this point of time, but he may be able to deliver other just by following it themselves in a pure fashion and to give other advice in a pure fashion, not to use their own mental concoction. Thus, to act as a Diksha Guru in ISKCON means to serve under the GBC and in cooperation with other ISKCON authorities by functioning as a regular guru. as Srila Prabhupada has directed. This statement, while conclusive, is not exhaustive in a discussion of these principles. The GBC may authorize additional statement and paper in the future to further explain the preeminent position of our founder, Acharya Srila Prabhupada, the roles and responsibility, those who serve as guru in our society, and the related duties of ISKCON members and other initiates. So this GBC body is basically made so that they can see that if there are any deviations or not in this, in the properly following the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. So all the gurus as well, they are working under GBC. If GBC are giving some instruction, all the initiating spiritual master also have to follow. Because this following the order of GBC is also one of the order of spiritual master. And if someone will have full faith on the orders of spiritual master, then he will make progress. There is no point saying that I am following Srila Prabhupada, I am following my initiating spiritual master, but I will not follow the GBC. Then this is also saying that I will not follow Srila Prabhupada's instruction. So one should try to follow the instructions carefully and properly, and then they will make a spiritual progress. Hare Krishna. Any questions or queries someone is having? Because this is a long topic, we little bit extended over time. If someone is having any query, they can raise it to me. Or they can later call me. They can tell me any, if they are facing any personal problems, anything they shall be able to share with me. So, if any queries right now, otherwise I will close this call. I will share the links to the various movies, small movies or trailers which are made on the Srila Prabhupada life. So, as an homework, you try to go through it, because if you will, you will be able to make some connection with Srila Prabhupada, then you can understand that some part of your life is anyways becoming perfect. If you make connection with Srila Prabhupada, then you can understand that your path back home, back to Godhead, has become very much clear. And if you start following it, then definitely you are going back home, back to Godhead. But at least one should, every devotee should make some connection with Srila Prabhupada. They should try to read his books, make connection more and more by reading his books, listening to his lecture. Whenever you get time, there are small snippets lecture, that is 5-7 minutes lecture cuttings of Srila Prabhupada's lecture. And if you will hear from pure devotee, then automatically it will go directly inside your heart, and then you will get the perfect realization. So when I would encourage everyone to seek more and more association of Srila Prabhupada teachings. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thanks. Hare Krishna. Thanks for your time.